Well, this time of year, fields, woods, and even your yard become nurseries for countless birds and small mammals.
Unfortunately, many of these babies fall prey to some free roaming house cats, but you can prevent any injury to the babies. NewsHub's Jack Hubley has tips in today's Wild Moments.
This week, we forego less controversial topics like healthcare and Afghanistan to jump into the real frying pan, free roaming cats. Patty Pope's question represents countless emails and phone calls I receive each year. Dear Jack, my elderly mother enjoys watching the wild birds as they visit our various bird feeders. Unfortunately, some neighborhood cats are taking advantage of this and feasting on our feathered friends. Is there something that we can do to discourage them? Well, Patty, there are a couple of Band-Aid treatments that can help. Locate your feeders away from low vegetative cover where cats can lie in ambush. And you can also equip your yard with a fence and a big dog. Now to the heart of the problem, people. That is, people who think it's okay to allow their cats to run free and reproduce at will. The free-roaming cat problem in this country is epidemic, and many studies have documented the house cat's devastating impact on wildlife. Spring, of course, is the high-impact season, when many species of birds and mammals lose their young to cats. One option that has gained popularity in recent years is called TNR, short for Trap, Neuter, Release. Proponents prefer this solution because the cats are allowed to live. But TNR fails to address the problem of unleashing an army of artificially produced meat eaters on an ecosystem that's not equipped to feed them. Every bird and small mammal that free-roaming cats kill is another meal taken from the mouths of those predators that must hunt for a living. Those hawks, owls, foxes, and snakes, just to name a few. And who takes responsibility for the neutered and released cat that scratches or bites a child or pet and transmits disease? So while TNR may be better than nothing, it's not good enough. And no solution will be good enough until pet owners take that first half of the term, house cat, seriously. I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.
And keeping your cats indoors may actually save lives, the lives of the cats, that is. Jack tells us that many free-roaming cats die from diseases like rabies or they get hit by cars.
It sounds like the world is just one big smorgasbord out there.